On June 19, 1865, a group of slaves in Galveston, Texas, the last in America, found out they were free. Blacks in Milwaukee celebrate that occasion every year. This year's festival marks the 10th anniversary that Milwaukeeans have been celebrating. Over 75,000 people came out to partake in the festivities. Games, entertainment, and plenty of food will be found. I talked with Jan Kemp, coordinator of the Juneteenth Day Planning Committee. Ms. Kemp, what does Juneteenth Day symbolize?
It symbolizes the freeing of the slaves in the territories in 1865. And actually, I guess what we're working on is that it's the black man's 4th of July.
How long have you been celebrating Juneteenth Day in Milwaukee?
This is our 10th anniversary.
How many people would normally turn out for a Juneteenth Day?
Well, according to the papers, I think we had around 75,000 during the full course of 12 hours last year. With the weather and the gods being nice, I think we might do that or top it today.
I understand that Texas has made Juneteenth Day a state holiday. Is there any plans to make a state holiday in Wisconsin?
Well, we've been talking about it, but I guess we need to talk to the powers that be and see if they feel the same. I think today was representative of the support that we have from the state, city, and local politicians. The governor will be joining us at 4 o'clock this afternoon, so I think we'd ask the support to move that way.
It's up to you. What's your pleasure?
Everyone around the world.
Come on!
It's a celebration.
Juneteenth Day would not be complete without the local beauties present. Miss Black Wisconsin and her court were there.
It's a celebration.
Celebrate good times. Come on.
People in the streets told me their favorite thing about Juneteenth Day.
Just to get out and have a little fun in a different city and knowing more about the community.
The crowd, the people, and how they're enjoying it.
All the people getting together, you know, just coming to see what different people have.
Women. Women. I'm serious. I'm serious. I love all the pretty women down there.
Buy some. You get to buy some.
Falafel.
The food.
You having a good time Juneteenth Day?
No.
Good time? Why not?
I don't celebrate it.
You don't?
No.
What do you think about
Juneteenth? I'm crazy about Juneteenth Day because I get to sell a lot of stuff, fried pies, brownies, and cookies, chicken cake. Oh, I just think it's great.
Although a party mood filled the air, some community leaders explain that Juneteenth Day also has a serious message.
We ought to remember, basically, that we're still slaves in this country. We have to remember that. The point of departure for us must be that we must know who we are. And once we know who we are, then we can begin to address ourselves to the question of how do we pull ourselves up our own bootstrap? How do we utilize the resources within our own community? And I'm thinking in terms of buying from black businesses, helping black businesses to get off the ground. I'm thinking in terms of teaching, training our own children at home. I'm thinking in terms of getting our own people to have a greater sense of pride and dignity and self-worth in themselves so that they don't get on the welfare treadmill, so that we don't begin to become junkies, federal junkies, as Mayor Gibson of Newark says, depending on the federal government, the state governments to take care of us. We must take care of ourselves. Nobody is going to help us but us, and we must remember that.
It's a very few times where you get such a versatility of people of African heritage, so to speak, to get together and just for once enjoy themselves come out of the misery of the everyday living that they have to go through trying to survive in this country.
Well, I think that education is critical in a society like this one, and I'm very concerned, as are a lot of people, with the fact that many of our children are being turned out of schools, unable to really read and write, which means they will not be able to compete and survive in this society. So obviously education has to be one of our critical concerns.
Juneteenth Day is a celebration, as I'm sure has been said before, that it's a celebration of when the people of Oklahoma and Texas found out that the North had won the war between the states, the Civil War, and that they were now free. The Emancipation Proclamation had been issued. And it was a symbol of a new beginning, and that's what it's meant to the city of Milwaukee and the state of Wisconsin the last 10 years. years. Now we have this new building, the DNR building, which in a way marks a new beginning for the 3rd Street corridor and a new beginning for the economic community on the north side of City of Milwaukee. I hope it's the beginning of a trend that will continue with the placement of other governmental and private sector businesses and buildings on the north side of the city.
Let's listen to some minority community announcements.